Welcome to this short introduction to A-Level Music at Tiffin. All of the music you will hear in this short presentation has been performed or composed by Tiffin pupils. My name is Mr. O'Malley, and along with my colleagues, we work with Tiffin A-Level Music students to help them not only study the A-Level Music course, but also develop their musical skills and experience beyond the classroom. There is an exceptional range of musical opportunities at Tiffin. Tiffin musicians regularly perform with professional orchestras and choruses at major venues in the UK and beyond. They perform in Hollywood films, on national radio and television, and on CD. They've toured Europe, China, and Australia. Music is a popular subject at Tiffin, with over 20 musicians studying the A-level music course as I speak, an unusually large number for this subject, which is not even available in many state schools. Each year, the school offers music scholarships and awards to pupils joining the sixth form, both from within the school and from other schools. Tiffin's many sixth form musicians help to make not only our A-level music classes, but also co-curricular music in the sixth form vibrant and successful. Many Tiffin students have gained places to study music at top universities and conservatoires. Many more have been awarded university music scholarships, allowing them to study a wide range of subjects at Russell Group universities, including Cambridge and Oxford, whilst continuing to perform music at the highest level. This presentation gives only the briefest of introductions to studying A-level music at Tiffin. To learn more about the A-level music course and the many musical opportunities here, including sixth form music scholarships, I encourage you to visit the Tiffin Music website. Simply search Tiffin Music, enter the address you see on your screen, or follow one of the links below. The Tiffin Music site, which receives 25,000 visits each year from around the world, provides not only information about curricula and co-curricular music at Tiffin, but also learning resources which pupils use to study Key Stage 3, GCSE, and of course, A-level music. If you would like to discuss the course, I would be delighted to invite you to a video meeting to answer any questions you might have. Please email me, mo'malley@tiffin.kingston.sch.uk, and I will do my best to get in touch. So, why study A-level music? Well, firstly, if you are watching this presentation, it's likely that you love music, and you've enjoyed dedicating many hours of free time to playing, singing, listening to, and maybe even composing it. You will most likely continue to enjoy doing these things whether you study the A-level music course or not. So, why not turn this passion and dedication into a qualification, which can be used to apply to university? For example, you might plan to take Grade 7 or Grade 8 exam on your chosen instrument or voice. Just by recording and submitting these pieces, you can achieve full marks in the first 30% of the A-level music course. Secondly, the A-level music course is highly regarded by all universities and colleges, regardless of the university subject you are applying to study. Although some universities have in the past published lists of non-preferred A-level subjects, music has never featured on these lists, because its logical, analytical, and essay writing components make the music A-level course as valuable as any humanities or language subject in the skills which it develops. Thirdly, speaking of these skills, choosing A-level music will help to make your sixth form studies as varied and as interesting as possible. As you move from studying 10 to just 3 or 4 subjects, A-level music will keep your timetable balanced and varied through a wide range of activities: performing, composing, analysing musical scores, listening critically, and writing about the historical and social context of music. If, for example, you also study A-level maths and physics, or history and politics, A-level music complements these by developing similar logical, analytical, and writing skills, but through a more diverse range of tasks. Finally, the best reason to study A-level music is because you enjoy it. All A-level subjects require dedicated, independent study to achieve success, far more than at GCSE. Experience shows that the more you enjoy a subject, the more you will commit to that independent study, and the more successful you will therefore be. As long as you enjoy music, we can help you succeed. At Tiffin, pupils study the EdExcel A-Level Music course. Like most GCSE music courses, the A-Level course is divided into three components: performing, composing, and appraising. Performing, which represents the first 30% of your A-Level grade, and composing, which represents the next 30%, are both completed as coursework. This means you can earn 60% of your A-level music marks with confidence long before facing the pressures of your final A-level exams. This complements and compares very favourably with most other A-level subjects, which are no longer modular and rest heavily on just two or three final exam papers. Performing is the first component of the A-level music course. At A-level, students are required to record one solo recital, which is at least 8 minutes long. They are encouraged to perform a program of their choice on their first study instrument or voice, that is, the instrument on which they have reached the highest standard. Depending on the instrument, the recital is normally performed with piano accompaniment or backing track. During the course, students are strongly encouraged to learn to perform music which is grade 8 in standard, increasing their raw mark by 50%. For example, students might perform three pieces of music from the Grade 8 ABRSM, Trinity Guildhall, or Rock School syllabuses, but they might also choose other Grade 8 difficulty pieces which are not set for exams. EdExcel lists hundreds of pieces it considers to be at least Grade 8 in difficulty in its Difficulty Levels booklet, found on the A-level performing pages of the Tiffin Music website. Most importantly, students are encouraged to record their recital as many times as they wish during the course, and select their best recordings from the final 2 months, meaning that all students have the opportunity to submit their best work at the end of the course. Composing is the second component of the A-level music course, taking the form of two pieces of coursework: a free composition representing 20%, and a technical study representing 10% of the A-level grade. At GCSE, Tiffin students will recall that they chose from a set of harmonic templates on which to base two compositions, a theme and variations for piano and a pop song. At A-level, students now compose a single composition, at least 5 minutes in length, in a genre and form of their choice. Instead of a given template, students are asked to find a model composition, that is, a piece of music which they admire and which they will study to understand techniques for use in their own composition. The feature which most clearly defines the highest scoring A-level compositions is harmonic ambition. Modernist music and jazz from the 20th and 21st centuries, with complex chromatic harmony, make excellent models. The second piece of composing coursework, the technical study, is completed at the end of the course during the 3 hours of lessons. During the course, pupils study the conventions used by J.S. Bach to harmonize a set of simple melodies which we know as his chorales. By following the conventions established by Bach and used by many composers since, students learn to compose their own harmonizations of simple chorale melodies, that is, choosing the correct chord to accompany each note of the melody. As their final coursework, students submit harmonizations of two chorale melodies set by the exam board. The third and final component of the A-level music course is appraising. This represents 40% of the A-level grade and takes the form of a final exam. It centers around an anthology of 18 set works, that is, six different areas of study, each comprising three pieces of music. The works come from a wide range of periods and genres, from Bach to Kate Bush, from Debussy to Danny Elfman, and from Stravinsky to Anoushka Shchenkar. Students analyze the set works by listening, studying the notated score, and by answering questions about the works. The analysis focuses on how each piece uses the elements of music, including structure, tonality, melody, harmony, texture, and others, and how this compares with other music previously heard, played, or studied by the pupils. The exam takes the form of short answer questions followed by two essay questions. For the short answer questions, each student is given their own CD, allowing them to listen to brief excerpts from the set works as they follow a skeleton score. These questions focus on close analysis, identifying chords and compositional devices in given bars or phrases. For the essay question, which follows, the student listens to a piece of unfamiliar music, one not studied in class, and comments on its use of musical elements by comparing it to related set works. In the final essay question, the student chooses to analyze the use of three elements of music in one of three set works, placing the work in its social and historical context. If you would like to discuss the course, I would be delighted to invite you to a video meeting to answer any questions you might have. Please email me, momalley@tiffin.kingston.sch.uk, and I will do my best to get in touch. Thank you for watching this short introduction to A-level music. I hope you will continue to watch as we now share with you this introduction to the many other musical opportunities at Tiffin.
My life, I miss you so bad, I miss you so bad. I missed you so, so bad. Before you came into my life, I missed you so bad. And you should know that I missed you so, so bad.